have found the one place where we will cover everything about editing in our FNC DataGrid components. In this video, we will cover how you can specify what kind of inplace editor to use in specific grid cells or grid columns, what kind of inplace editors there are out of the box available for the FNC DataGrid, and how you can select these, how you can also further change the characteristics of these out-of-the-box in-place editors for the grid. And finally, we will also show you in this video how you can use your own controls or other controls as in-place editors in the FNC data grid. So come with me and let's dive into the Delphi IDE, where I will show you everything in detail. And let's dive into this right away. Here we are in the Delphi 12.2 IDE, and let's create a new project. We'll create a new VCL application. And as you know, the FNC data grid can be used within a VCL application, a FireMonkey application, and also a WebCore web application. We'll start here today with this VCL application where we drop the default grid on the form. This is the FNC data grid. And first of all, I want to have a look together with you here at what is available at design time to configure the editing in the data grid. And first, I want to bring the options editing enabled property here for you, which controls globally in the grid whether editing is available or not. I can also column-wise control whether editing is allowed or not via the columns collection editor that is shown here. And as you can see, we have here the read-only property with which we can make a column at once read-only or not. We also see all the types of in-place editors that are available out of the box. And as you can see, there are already a lot and a lot of in-place editors available in the grid. You see combo boxes, date picker, all kinds of editors where you specify that the entry should be uppercase, lowercase, numbers, numbers with a sign or not. Also an HTML editor can be invoked, a color picker, and so on. So a lot of in-place editors already available out of the box. Note that if you want column-wise that the editor property is applied to that specific column, do not forget to here check that this setting will be applied. This is what you can specify at design time, column-wise, but of course you can also via code customize the in-place editing. And that can be done in several ways. It can be done, first of all, to control whether a cell is read-only or not via the onCanEdit cell event handler. The parameter aCanEdit controls whether the cell can be edited or not. To specify the editor type, we will be using the onGet inplace editor type event handler. And here I can write something, for example, like a cell.column. If that equals one, then we specify the inplace editor type, for example, as a combo box. Okay, that specifies via code that in column one we will use a combo box in place editor. Now, if we talk about a combo box, we of course also need to specify what combo box items we will want to see. And we can again do that column wise via the editor items. These are the items that can be shown in a combo box dropdown. But we can also do that via code. And to do that via code, we will want to use the event handler onGetInPlaceEditor properties. And this event handler is specified right before the in-place editing starts. I prepared a code snippet to show you how you can control this. And here you can see that if this particular cell that is about to be edited is a combo box, then we add three items in the combo box dropdown to choose from. And let's already run this application and see the result in effect. So it was the first column, and here you can see the items that we specified in code in this dropdown. Next, I want to show you how you can use a custom property editor for the grid. And what we will do for this example is use the FNC date picker as an in-place editor for the data grid. Normally, by default, when I pick in the columns editor, for example, here under editor, the date picker that you can see this one here. When I choose this one, this is the default operating system date picker control. On Windows, for example, this is what you are used to with the VCL date time picker class. And this is maps on the operating system date time picker. Our FNC date picker that we wrote from scratch has a lot of extra capabilities and capabilities that you can take advantage of also as in-place editor for the data grid. So here you see our FNC date picker, and if I select that, you can see, for example, that there is a lot of customizing that you can do with the background fill, the date appearance, how it looks like. So numerous properties to control how it appears, also how it behaves, with, for example, the capability to set a minimum date, maximum date, and so on. So let's dive now into using that date picker as an in-place editor for the grid. And we will also do this dynamically via event handling. And so first of all, we will use this onget editor type event handler. And for column 2, we will specify a custom in-place editor. So we set this to custom, like this, custom, okay. And if we specify a custom in-place editor, we have the in-place editor class. And this event handler asks us what type, what the class will be for this custom in-place editor. And here we can specify, for example, if the cell dot column equals 2, then our class will be the TMS FNC date picker class. And that means that our data grid will actually create an instance of that class as in-place editor for our grid. And now, what we want to do is also further customize the settings of this data grid dynamically via code. And we also prepared a code snippet for that. And I will copy and paste this code snippet. So what we do here is if our in-place editor is a date picker, we will specify the minimum date, the 1st of December 24, and the maximum date, the last day of December, meaning that we will only allow entry of dates in the month of December. There is one more thing that we need to do. Here we use a date picker. The grid does not know per se how to get and set the value in that date picker in the cell and from the cell to the actual value in the date picker. And that's where we use the on-cell edit get data event for. And this is the code that we use for that. So let's copy and paste. And here you can see that in the get data, I'm getting the value of the cell and use that for the selected date in the date picker. So when editing starts, when editing stops, I need to do the reverse, and this is the piece of code for the reverse operation. Here I specify in the value the selected date. One more thing to finish is specifying the format with which this will be displayed, and here I need to specify that this column contains a date time so that the grid knows that it should format the value as a date time. So let's have a look now at how this inplace editing is now customized for this column via the date picker. You can see that I can select only dates in December, so these are the only active dates I can select from. And you can see how these values are displayed in the grid. And this way, we can actually use any kind of control as inplace editor. Here I showed you how you can use our date picker, FNC date picker, with many more customization capabilities, also as an inplace editor for the data grid. And here we have a much more extensive sample prepared especially for you. You can actually also download the full source code of this example in the link here under the video. So download it from there and you will be able to start it right away in your IDE and explore what this demo is doing. I'm quickly going over the code where in the form create, we are in code setting up the grid and all its in-place editing capabilities here. So here you can see that in the first column, the name column, we are invoking the HTML editor. We are adding some HTML to grid cells. In the second column, we are using the date picker as in-place editor. Here we are using a combo box, and you can see here that we use the columns editor items property to specify the items in the combo box dropdown. We'll also use a track bar here in column number four, and color picker, and some predefined color settings, colors that we will allow the user to choose from via this color picker editor. And finally, we also have here in this example a custom control as property editor for the last column in the grid. And some more words of detail after I have been running and showing you this example. So this is the application when I have run it. And here we have regular editing, so nothing special to see here. But here, remember that we have specified the HTML editor as in-place editor. So when I now double-click this cell, you can see that we have an HTML editor available. And so we can edit the content of the cell as HTML. We have the operating system, date picker here, for example. Here we have the combo box. Note that we have also this direct drop-down configuration, and that means if I click the cell, no clicking two times required, it opens up in a drop-down right away. The track bar is what was used for this number column, and so this is how I can use a track bar to edit here a numeric value. The color drop-down, where we have added these 10 custom colors, is also something that you can choose, and there is some further customization where we specify here the color as HTML, something that we also added here in this example. And finally, we have this custom control, and this opens up as in place editor a panel that contains a label and a button, and from the button click event handler I can change the value to a random value. So let's have a look at how that was achieved. And we created for that the custom editor class, which descends from a panel. So it is a panel that will host that label and a button. And we exposed a value property. It is the value property with which we get and set the value of the label to the cell. The data grid is smart enough to find out via RTTY if the custom in place editor has a value property, and will do all the work itself to get and set that value of the in place editor according to the value of the cell. So if we go and have a look at the constructor of our custom editor, you can see that we are creating a label here, creating a button, and specify a button click handler, and that simply makes or sets a random value between 0 and 100 to this label. And it does that via the value property. And here you can actually see that it retrieves or sets the value via the label text property. And how we specify this custom editor as the editor for the last column, here you can see, as we did for the FNC date picker, you can see that we also use the onGetInPlaceEditor class, and we simply specify the custom editor. So that is the class that we defined here in our code as the class for editing in the last column. And here, no need for the onEdit get cell data and onEdit set cell data, because as I explained, the grid is smart enough to find out via RTTY if there is a value property, and if so, it will use that value property. And with that, I think you already have a quite sophisticated example of how to use in-place editing in the grid and use a variety of types of in-place editors. And with that, we finish this third installment of videos dedicated to all the capabilities of our FNC data grid. Stay tuned, subscribe here under this video to see the further sequels of this series on the FNC data grid. Meanwhile, go and have a look, download the free trial version of the data grid, and you can explore these editing capabilities and much, much more on your own and your own IDE. Experiment with it, test with it, and finally successfully integrate it into your applications. Much success, and stay tuned for the next installment of this video series on FNC DataGrid.